As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. The Panthers out in front, and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well, and most importantly, partner.
Yeah, they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
It'll go as a gain of four, and that'll bring up second down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Here's Johnson to throw on second down. His throw incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. To throw Johnson, and tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete. So no problems moving the ball in the first half, but they'll likely come up empty here on drive one of quarter three.
And it was so important for the defense to get that stop, because what we witnessed in the first half was them getting run over, and they needed the confidence, and they needed to get off the field so they felt good going forward in this game.
It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them.
And Prescott, his third interception. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes they kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half. And for this defense, they take advantage, turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. And as confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
Santos with the extra point, and they open the lead up now to 25. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. We'll see a return here from the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Give him 15 there, and the Cowboys have a first.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. Now they'll run on the draw. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. To throw is Prescott. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Chalk that up as their first sack in this game, and they tallied four a week ago.
And probably not as much exultation in that sack as what took us so long. Because when you get four the previous week, you're counting on continuing that momentum. They didn't get that done in the first half of the game. Let's see now if they start to bring even more exotic pressure towards the quarterback.
And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion.
Maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I wonder if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game, because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long, but a nice throw there for a good gain and a first down.
A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Now on second and 13, Prescott got his man complete over the middle. It's Schultz. Touchdown, Cowboys! Well, if they're going to make a game of this in the second half, they need a few big plays to go their way. That's one.
And the way to get it done is to also conserve time. So to your point, that big play right there, now you're not moving the ball downfield, taking time off the clock. You're leaving yourself a better avenue to continue to try and make a comeback.
Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is down to 28-10. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Still operating with a comfortable lead despite the score a moment ago as they begin first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Johnson. Got a man over the middle and it's complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. 23 yards on the play. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Off the play fake. Johnson. Wide open. It's Marshall complete. He's got room at the 30. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Last play, they went over 20 yards. This time, they top 30.
A very nice job right there, working the middle of the field, able to create some separation, and then utilize it to not just make the catch, but turn up field once he got the ball in his hands.
Johnson on first down. This is caught. Touchdown. Terrace Marshall, 26 yards, as his guys are able to push that lead out a bit further.
So another touchdown there, and even though we're still just here in the third quarter, kind of hard now to see them giving up this lead.
And this is just an offense that's imposing its will right now. You name it, they're able to do it. If you're the play caller, whatever you want to select is there. You want to run it, you want to throw it, pick a play, any play. They're rocking and rolling right now.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 16. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. So they will take the sack instead of the penalty.
And it takes another down off the series. But the biggest one of all, do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No.
No, not at all.
After the penalty, it's Elliott. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7.
Now that ground game just continues to struggle to really get any momentum in this ballgame, Charles. And I mean, you're at the point here, third quarter, down 4 scores, probably going to have to put it in the air.
Oh, no question about it. So that's...
They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. It's C.J. Henderson picking it off. And the Cowboys are going to take possession of the football.
Wait a second. They declined the penalty?
I'm as puzzled as you are, partner. I don't understand how any time you lose possession of the ball, yet you turn down a penalty that would give you possession back. Let's make this simple. Anyone who plays the game, take the football. Always take the football.
Now a play fake here on first down. Out to his left. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
And he is out of bounds. Looks like right at the 15. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains.
Now Johnson to throw on third down. Over the middle, that's complete to McCaffrey. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Looking to throw. Johnson. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Christian McCaffrey. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Panthers get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead.
Santos able to tack on the extra point. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Cowboys 10.
The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away.
On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And a nice job there on special teams, delivered him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14.
in this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Well, this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really... And now here is another interception. And the Panthers are going to take possession of the football. Well, that is now his fifth interception thrown in this game. And, Charles, you've got to tip your cap to this defense. I mean, they have been so impressive reading these passes, stepping in those lanes, and picking them off.
Yeah, sometimes the best offense is an excellent defense, and they've done exactly that. What do you think, partner? A season's worth of highlights in just four quarters? I think that's what we're seeing from this group.
Escaping the pressure right, and he'll just get rid of it.
I think we can all understand what they're thinking right now. They take over the ball in field goal range after the turnover, so they've got that in their hip pocket. But they've got to go for the end zone and turn this into a bigger point. Their thinking is a touchdown is really what they should get from starting here. Getting 3 points at the end of this drive, that would feel disappointing.
Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
Johnson now, throwing on first down, and he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers, from 10 yards out, and the Panthers are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. Santos with the extra point, and the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but... I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. Now they're staring at a third and eight. That last play backwards a yard.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield in man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
Here's Brian Anger now as he'll kick it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. A 40-yard punt, no return, and it will be the Panthers' ball, first and 10. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Well, they don't really need the points here, Charles, given what we're looking at on the scoreboard, but they've scored on three consecutive possessions, three consecutive drives, and I'm sure that they would like to keep that streak going here and continuing to pour it on.
And things have gotten that way in the NFL, haven't they, partner? Because in the old days, people would, you know, they'd get off the gas a little bit, right? But now, people continue to accelerate
into a double team, and it's intercepted. And the Cowboys are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield.
The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
Amari Barno getting there to make the stop. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. A 20th carry here for Elliott. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the...
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And the Panthers are going to get it back here just past the 35.
Good starting position for the Panthers as they come up first and 10 at their 36-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And this one is incomplete.
Partner, in the sportsmanship handbook, there's something to be said for calling the dogs off in a blowout. But these defenders, they also know this is the NFL, and it's their job to stop them, whether they're in the game or they're down by a handful of touchdowns.
Here's Johnson, throwing again on second and 10. He finds Hillman. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48.
Partner, I know we're still in the afternoon slate here. Some primetime games still on the docket, but it's going to be tough to top this effort. What an offensive performance we have seen. They have been unstoppable from the moment we began this game. And they're not holding back. They're still throwing the football here in the fourth.
They certainly are. And let me tell you something. If you're old school, you don't like this at all. But in today's football, you just go ahead and savor it. Watch a team execute at a high level. Doesn't matter what the scoreboard says.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack.
Oso Odighizuwa with the effort there to earn the sack.
If we go back to the last series, remember, their coverage allowed them to get a turnover in the last drive, a takeaway, and that helped contribute to a sack on this one. I think maybe his quarterback's a little bit hesitant. Last time he turned it over, now he sees his zone coverage a little bit slow to get rid of the football.
They need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he's got his big tight end here. And he's going to be stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that'll bring up fourth down. Off play action. Johnson. Going to hook up with his big tight end, complete. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30.
So they convert on fourth, and now from just outside the 30, here's first and 10.
He's got a man, that's Marshall. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards.
Tell you what, Barney, the way he's been slinging it in this one, I think he should be ticketed for a baseball cap and a set of headphones for the next drive. He's been absolutely sensational.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Malik Hooker. And the Cowboys force the turnover, and they'll take over at the 10.
Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How things turn out for him?
I think, okay, he's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Again, it's Elliott. And he stopped immediately there. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. But bottom line is, he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. On third down, Elliott. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Here's Brian Anger now as he's on to punt for Dallas. This will be a 41-yard punt, three on the return. And the Panthers will take over in terrific field position. That one looks like he'll throw here. That pass complete to Moore. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33. Well, there's absolutely been no stopping this offense today. They already have the big lead, obviously. Here in the fourth quarter, they could coast to the end. But right now, they're not passing up any chances to put up some garbage time yardage.
And, Bartner, why would they? Because who knows the next time you'll be playing as well as you have today. When you're in that zone, you go ahead and take full advantage of it. You don't worry about your opponent. You just worry about what you're doing.
Got his big tight end over the middle, complete. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
First down, Carolina.
Back to throw, Johnson. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Kelvin Joseph. And the Cowboys are going to take over once again, and they'll have it at their own 8-yard line. Boy, Charles, you hate to see this for a rookie quarterback. You're hoping it doesn't shake his confidence, but that confidence, it might be shaken because that is four interceptions for him now in this ballgame.
It has to be shaken. Wouldn't be human if you weren't. Doesn't matter whether you're a rookie or a veteran. Four interceptions, you're not sure what you're doing out there. So to me as a coaching staff, I would think very hard about getting him out and trying it again another day.
And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. They keep on the ground with Elliott. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. On second down, Elliott. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped by the line of scrimmage. And as this defense walks off the field, they can do...